In my dreams, I go back to the year 1795, to a time when I was happy. I was on my way to be married. I was going to the house in which I was to find my days filled with fear, my nights filled with horror.
Over 300 years ago.
Is there a ghost?
Ghosts galore. Headless horsemen, horseless headsmen, everything.
Family tree?
Oh, yes, they're all here. From the highest to the lowest.
Oh, that's a good portrait. Who is he?
Uncle Frederick Fengriffen, said to be by Hogarth.
Really?
No. Now, Uncle Frederick came back from the Indies in 1765. Hogarth died in 1764.
Oh, after Hogarth.
Sir Peter Fengriffen, the fox hunter. Sir Thomas Fengriffen, the witch hunter.
Who's he?
Oh, that's my grandfather, Sir Henry. Sir Henry Fengriffen. My ancestors, I'll go and see that your room is ready. Thank you.
It was all in her imagination.
Why that?
Apart from the legacies to the servants, which you can copy from the present will, I want my wife to be sole beneficiary of the estate. That is, until we have children, of course. What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing.
See? Catherine, there's nothing there.
Thank you.
Catherine, what's the matter?
There was a man.
Come sit down.
He had a red scar like a birthmark, and he was dressed in rags and bits of old leather. Who is he? Do you know who he is?
He's a sort of woodsman.
Yours?
No one's.
What's he doing on the estate?
Well, he lives here.
Ah, Mrs. Luke. Do you know anything about the woodsman who lives in the grounds?
I think you'd best ask the master, m'lady.
Do you?
No, m'lady. The servants on the estate come under the bailiff. I'm only responsible for those inside the house.
Is he a servant?
No. Not exactly.
Well, what is he then? What is he?
This new time, I'll give it your name.
Didn't you hear me?
Oh, yes. I heard you, mistress.
Then why didn't you answer?
I have to hear. Nothing says I have to answer.
I want to talk to you.
I'm listening.
Take your hands out of the water.
Which one would you like first, mistress?
Either.
Either. Well, as I am right-handed, how about this one? Is that the one you wanted?
Now the other one.
You want to see this one?
I just said so.
Two hands, you see. Eight fingers, two thumbs, back, front, nothing special about it.
Who are you?
Silas, son of Silas.
And what do you do?
I'm a woodsman. You have trouble with an elm, an ash. Trouble with anything. You just send for me.
How long have you lived here?
All my life. My father before me. The master's grandfather gave us the land.
Grandfather?
Henry Fengriffen.
Tell me about your grandfather.
What do you want to know?
What sort of a man was he? What did he do?
I have no idea. He died long before I was born. He farmed the estate.
I spoke to the woodsman today. He says Sir Henry gave his family the land. Why did he?
I don't know. It all happened a long time ago. 50 years at least.
On the estate, there's a cottage, a hovel. A woodsman lives there.
Silas.
You know him?
I know of him.
He says Sir Henry gave his family the land.
That is true.
Why?
I'm not at liberty to reveal information which has been entrusted to me.
You're the family solicitor. You must tell me.
I cannot without first speaking to your husband.
I've asked him. He refuses to tell me anything. But I must know. Our marriage, perhaps our very lives, may depend upon it.
Return to Fengriffen and tell Sir Charles I will come to see him later tonight.
If you can help me, I'll be eternally grateful.
I'll try.
Thank you.
Show Lady Fengriffen to her coach, Peter. I will try.
Ride out, see if I can find Lawyer Maitland. He should have been here 2 hours ago. He shan't be long. Thank you.
guilty child.
Oh, that window.
It could be one of two things. A boy or a girl. Congratulations to you both. Going to take her away?
Take her away?
To have the baby?
Certainly not.
Have you no fear of what might happen?
Every Fengriffen for the past 300 years has been born here. So will he.
He?
It'll be a boy. I'm sure of that. An heir to Fengriffen.
Charles, for God's sake, you must tell her.
No.
Then I will.
Will you?
No.
You believe in it, then?
After what happened to Maitland?
Maitland was murdered. We don't know why or by whom. But his killer will be found. His killer must be found.
Come, come now, Silas. Save time. Tell us why you did it. Who else round here owns a long-handled axe?
Every farmer. Every smallholder.
But they weren't in Brinkton Wood last night.
Nor was I.
Morning, Charles.
Morning, Sir John.
Morning, Sir Charles.
Morning. Has he confessed yet?
Says he didn't do it.
Who else could it be?
Wasn't me, Master. My time is coming.
You haven't eaten any breakfast. You must eat.
I don't want anything.
Well, think of the baby.
I don't want the baby.
Why?
You know why. You all know. But no one will tell me. What is it? Please, tell me.
I can't. Why? I'm afraid.
Afraid? Of what?
Afraid of what? I can't tell you, but I'll show you.
Oh.
Will there be anything else, milady? The master and Dr. Whittle think she must have fallen. Tripped on the stairs, most likely.
Thank you, Bridget. That will be all. I came here as your chaperone at your guardian's request. After your wedding, I decided to stay to protect you. But the time has come for us to go.
Go? Where to?
Back to London. Back to civilization.
Leave my husband.
I've ordered a carriage in the morning. Finish packing your things.
Aunt Edith was going to take me away from Fengriffen.
She died of natural causes. Her heart failed her. That's what Dr. Whittle said.
Mrs. Luke was going to show me something.
Mrs. Luke slipped on the stairs. It was an accident, Catherine.
Lawyer Maitland was going to persuade you to let him tell me something. What was it? Please tell me. Please.
Morning, Master.
How much do you want?
Want?
To get off my land.
Why would you want me to go?
Your presence disturbs my wife.
Oh, I wouldn't want to do that.
I want you to go.
This is my home. Always has been. My ancestral hovel.
Give you money. Enough to live in London, anywhere you want.
I stay here.
Why?
You know why. Thank you.
Some say no evil thing that walks by night in fog or fire, by lake or moorish fen, blue meager hag or stubborn unlaid ghost that breaks his magic chains at curfew time, no goblin or swart fairy of the mine hath hurtful power o'er true virginity.
Set your mind at rest. The baby's quite all right. Fetus wasn't harmed one little bit.
Thank God. And Catherine?
Only bruised.
I meant her mind.
I brought you a tonic. It'll help you and the child.
There must be something you can do for her.
I'm afraid not. These matters are beyond me.
But there must be someone who can help her, surely.
I know a doctor in London, well versed in a new science. His name is Dr. Pope.
was good of you to come so quickly, Dr. Pope. I expect you're tired and hungry.
More curious than tired. Curiosity is necessary in my particular practice. Dr. Whittle mentioned your wife's dreams. Can you elaborate on them at all?
No.
Do you know of anything that could be troubling her?
No, nothing, apart from her pregnancy.
That's a normal reaction. Has she been prescribed any medicine?
Dr. Whittle has given her a tonic.
If it contains laudanum, that can produce vivid dreams.
I don't think that these dreams are caused by any physic, Doctor. Would you like to see her? I'm afraid she's gone to bed, but I can...
Oh, no, no. Don't disturb her. I'll see her in the morning. Does she know why I'm here?
Well, she knows you're a doctor, but I haven't told her about your special field of study.
Oh, good.
Ah, Bridget. Can you show Dr. Pope to his room, please?
Yes, sir.
Good night, Doctor.
Good night.
Shall I unpack you, sir?
No, thank you. I can manage.
Forgive my asking, sir, but are you here about the mistress?
I am.
You won't be cutting into her, will you, sir?
Cutting?
Cutting into her body, I mean.
Good heavens, no. I'm not a surgeon.
It's my belief he's a priest, she needs not a doctor.
Very young for this position, Bridget.
Yes, sir.
How long have you had such responsibility?
Since Mrs. Luke's accident.
Oh? What sort of accident?
She fell down the stairs. Killed herself.
Did she? When was this knife resharpened?
After the mistress...
slashed the portrait. Dr. Pope.
Charles thinks I'm insane.
Unhappy, not insane.
Can you cure unhappiness, Doctor?
Yes, if I can find the cause.
What do you want me to do?
Talk.
About what?
Tell me what is making you unhappy. What about your dreams?
Dreams?
Yes. Such as the one I understand you had on the night of your wedding.
Charles went to his room to change. He left me here. I undressed. I was sitting at the dressing table. I noticed that the window, that one, was open. I closed it. There was a musty smell, a smell of the graveyard. I got into bed. Suddenly the candles went out. Then a hand was clamped over my mouth. A cold hand. And an arm pinned me to the bed. At the end of the arm, instead of a hand, there was a stump. Severed at the wrist. Covered with blood.
You say the candles went out?
Yes.
Yet you were able to see all this?
There was a fire. The logs were burning brightly.
Quite so. Quite so. Please go on.
Oh, I didn't...
Are there any stories connected with the house of Fengriffen?
Stories?
Yes. Gossip. Local legends. Superstitions. Ghosts?
None at all.
So there is something. You would not have denied it so vigorously if there wasn't. Tell me about it.
I can't.
Try.
It's too dangerous.
I came from London at your request to investigate a case which could be of some interest to those of us who study the science of the mind. Also, to help a lady in great distress. Now, I cannot do so if I am denied the facts, all the facts. You must tell me everything you know. Without your complete confidence, I am powerless.
There is a woodsman on the Fengriffen estate.
Fine morning for a walk, Dr. Pope.
How do you know who I am?
Is it the child you've come about?
What concern is that of yours?
If it dies, I'll kill you.
I thought you were lost. Good of you to come out looking for me. Last night I saw a man outside the window, a fellow in rags. Who is he?
His name is Silas. He's a woodsman.
I found him today in his cottage. He told me that if Lady Fengriffen's child dies, he'll kill me.
The man's mad. Besides, Dr. Whittle will be attending the delivery.
Dr. Whittle is dead. But before he died, he spoke of a legend. Your maid Bridget is of the opinion that a priest will be more helpful than a doctor. Your wife is terrified. Isn't it time you told me?
Told you what?
Whatever it is, you're keeping secret.
No.
Why not?
Because there's nothing to tell. You're a man of science, a doctor. I would never have married Catherine if I thought there was any truth in the story. The legend is mere superstition.
If you wish to cure your wife, you will have to disprove that legend. Not to our satisfaction, but to hers.
Sit down. The legend dates back to my grandfather Henry's time, about 50 years ago. He turned this place into a house of debauchery, ignored his wife and son, and filled the place with the scum of the earth.
Was a lady loveless wife, only could she.
It's little enough, Sarah, but it's a start.
It's lovely.
No, it's not. It's too hot in summer, too cold in winter, and too small all the year round.
It's ours. That's what counts. Now, are you going to put me down, Silas? Or are we going to stand around here talking about it all night?
Born, he bore, and 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 is still alive.
Just
rise, take up thy bottle and walk. What would it take to put you on your feet?
A wench.
Or a wench, huh? A plump, well-breasted virgin, all ready for the oven. How about that? How long since you saw one?
Yes. The eighth.
How would you like to see one tonight?
Tonight?
If we are not too late, that is. Come. It might be worth a ride. We've come to view your bride.
She is in bed, Master.
Quite right, too. Where else should she be on her wedding night? And what is your name, my dear?
Sarah.
Have you taken her yet? Well, have you?
No, Master.
Perhaps you'd like some help.
No help is needed.
He is the master.
Aye. The lord of the manor has that right.
Huh? Those days are long past.
An old custom is always worth reviving. Especially with a buxom beauty like, what's her name?
No!
What did you say? A servant daring to tell his master what he can do?
In his own house? With his own wife? Yes.
Step aside, we'll forget it ever happened. For the last time, step aside, I say. Get out of my way!
Hold him!
Get me some wine. Pull him round so he can watch. An old custom.
Silas! No!
Ha ha ha!
must learn respect, Silas. A servant without respect is like an unbroken horse. It must be disciplined.
Look out, she's got a knife!
Take him outside. All right. Get some water. Twice today, you've raised your hand against me. It shall not happen again. Put his arm on the block. Do you hear me? Come. Come there. You beg for mercy? What was that? I can't hear you. Then take justice.
Griffin, listen. The evil you did this day will be avenged. I swear a solemn vow. The next virgin bride to come to the house of Fengriffen will be violated, as was my Sarah. But then shall come the true vengeance on the house of Fengriffen. And death shall befall anyone who tries to prevent it.
What became of them?
Silas lived. And Sarah, too, if you can call it living. She had a child, but it died in infancy. And then she changed from a beautiful young girl into a hideous mockery of a woman. Now, Henry changed, too. He tried to make restitution, but Silas would accept nothing. Nothing, that is, until 20 years later, when his own son was born. A son to see the prophecy fulfilled. Silas, son of Silas.
Then he accepted for himself and his descendants the perpetual right to live on the Fengriffen estates free of any payment. And that is why you see the woodsman, their son, here, watching and waiting.
Thank you.
Malleus Maleficarum, written almost 300 years ago by two Dominican friars. Did you find it interesting?
I did.
The most sinister classic ever written on the subjects of demonology and witchcraft. It gave rise to the Inquisition and has caused torment and torture beyond reckoning. It's amazing when you consider there is not one scientific fact in nearly 600 pages.
You don't think so?
I know so. Half the evil in this world is caused by confusing the written word with reality.
Or legend with fact.
You've heard about this legend, and then in your imagination, these things happened.
No. These things happened. Then I heard about the legend. It's not the legend that haunts me. It's this. I live in the horror that this is the child of a ghost.
The legend said the next virgin bride. That would have been your mother.
No, my mother was a widow when she met my father.
Does your wife know that?
She might have found out. Doctor, will you stay here till the baby's born?
I will stay for as long as you wish.
Promised me something.
I'll do my best, my dear. What is it?
I want to see it first. The baby. Before Charles. Before anyone.
Very well.
Promise. You must promise.
You shall see your baby first. Four drops.
Is it a boy?
Son. Fine son.
Mm.
Stay with her.
Congratulations, Master. A son. A proper heir to Fengriffen.
I should have killed you years ago. Tell them he's dangerous and armed with an axe. Till I find him at the graveyard. Has she woken yet?
It's a boy, isn't it?
Yes.
May I see him?
He's asleep.
I want to see him.
I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers